ओके
क्या
क्लास टू से एनीथिंग
नो
सो टुमारो यू ऑल हैव क्लास टेस्ट फ्रॉम 10 AM टू 11 AM एंड द क्वेश्चंस विल बी गिवन थ्रू गूगल क्लासरूम द क्वेश्चंस विल बी गिवन 5 मिनट्स बिफोर द क्लास टेस्ट स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द क्लास टेस्ट सो देन आई विल गिव ऑल्सो शेयर वन लिंक गूगल मीट लिंक देयर लाइक योर क्लासेस द लिंक देयर and you will open your video your own video problems will given also there. Follow the numerical problems also given in the note. And when I was discussing in class, that these are very important. They are from this numericals are given. So total you have in MCQ 10 questions in MCQ 1 marks. Options will be given, 4 options will be given. So you will you have to write. And one thing, another thing, that what you will do when you will write in your paper, say question number 1 MCQ, option is B. You don't write only B, you will write B with that answer. What is given beside that option B, you will also write. Because this is very problematic in checking, only if you write B, C, D like this. So you will write the question number, say 1. If B is the answer, then write B. And after that, the answer you will write beside B. What is in B? That is for MCQ. And short answer type questions are also there. And for short answer type questions, 3 marks and 2 marks questions are there. Total, they are 20 marks. As a whole, you will get total 30 marks question. 30 marks in 1 hour. And in short answer type questions, 3 marks and 2 marks. Numericals also there. Very important. Numericals are very important. So go through it. The short answer type numerical. Vector, from vector you will get questions. Vector is very important. Numerical you will get from there. Numerical you can get from damp, force, vibration, SHM also. So go through the PPT. This question, can anyone say when a vector is solenoidal? What is the relation?
Solenoidal.
Then which one is zero?
Divergence dot A is equal to zero.
Divergence dot A vector.
And if curl of any vector is zero, then what is the vector called?
Rotational.
Okay. So what you will do in gradient, I have solved different problems on gradient. Okay. Gradient, divergence, curl. So different problems were given in divergent. So different problems may be given from divergent, gradient, divergence, and curl. One vector may be given, find out the gradient, divergence of curl, or grad square of something. Find out the grad square of something. So this problem, so follow, I'm saying that follow my PPTs, all the PPTs, whatever I have discussed there, follow the PPTs. And also there, different rules are there, what is the theorems are there, so write down the theorems, it also may be given. Force vibration, in force vibration think what will be the short answer type question, they write the expression, that whole, that may not be given. So expression may be given, for write the expression like this. And explain all these terms. That is derivation, say for 5 marks, 6 marks. So that will not be given. Big derivation, small derivation can be given. And after that derivation, different parts can be explained. So in force vibration, what are the, after the derivation, what are the parts there? Equation of force vibration, then solution of force vibration, then what is there after that? First. In force vibration, that write down the equation of force vibration, then find out the solution of force vibration. Then what is included there? After that, what I have discussed in force vibration? Say anyone.
Force vibration in LCR circuit.
That is different. Same thing. That is the example. Force vibration in LCR circuit. Okay. This is one example. But in force vibration, in theory part, what I have discussed? After the equation, its solution, then what I have discussed?
Ma'am, amplitude frequency.
What? Resonance. Amplitude resonance, velocity resonance, these are all. Okay. So the whole theory. So think about it. What will be given for short answer type question? It is not a long answer type question is given in this exam. But anything can be explained. They explain this in this way. This way is not given there, but short answer type question is given there. So think about it, what will be the short answer type question? So on different topics, short answer type questions may be given. Force vibration, what are the headlines given? So these are the headlines. If it can be derived if the derivation is big, it is not given. It may be given, and also the explanation of all these things, and also the definitions of all these things. And in vector, think about think that what are the definition? Definitions are important. So in vector, think what are the definitions that given in vector? Different theorems may be given, or so actually, what you will do? Go through my PPT. Force vibration in LCR circuit, and also in damped vibration, also electrical circuit I have discussed. Then different things are there. You have not mentioned relaxation time, quality factor. These are the things. And that time I also said that these are given. These problems are very important. They find out the quality factor. Say LCR values are given. Find out the relaxation time. So what you will do? Go through the numericals. Go through the notes. PPT notes. So that is my suggestion for tomorrow, because you have to on your video on yourself. Sharing screen is visible. So that is my discussion for today. So I'm not discussing much today, because tomorrow you have exam, and today that is Maxwell equation. Just I will start that equation, different equations. Maxwell's equations. So these are, it is given directly. So if you have a short answer type question in next class test, second class test, also may be given like this. Write down the Maxwell's equations. Write down the Maxwell equation and explain the terms like this. Maybe given for 3 marks, say. First equation, 4 Maxwell's equations are there. First one is divergence of E equal to rho by epsilon 0. This is the Gauss law. Actually, electrostatics is not in your syllabus, but previously it was given in your syllabus. Now, if it is, if it is included in your syllabus, then it is easier for your understanding this law, because derivation is there in Gauss law in electrostatics. And Gauss law in electrostatics, this is the differential form. There are two forms, differential form and integral form. So here in Maxwell's equation also, there are two Maxwell's equation. These are what are given here. These are the Maxwell's equation, the differential form of Maxwell equation. So four equations, 1, 2, 3, 4. First one is divergence of E equal to rho by epsilon 0. This is the Gauss law. Second one is divergence of B equal to 0. Magnetostatics. So divergence of B equal to 0. So what is the vector B? So magnetic field is dash in nature. What you will write? 0. This is the second Maxwell equation. From here, what you can write? So magnetic field is dash in nature. What you will write? Fill in the blanks. Magnetic field is dash in nature. Dash, I have asked before. Yes. So divergence of any vector is zero. Then that vector, this is solenoidal in nature. Now this divergence of this magnetic field is zero. So magnetic field is solenoidal in nature. Also, you can prove this. That is divergence of B equal to zero. Of equal to minus del B by del T is the electric field, and B is the magnetic field. And here curl of B equal to what? Mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 del E by del T. This is Ampere's law with Maxwell correction. So this is the Ampere circuital law. Actually, the Ampere circuital law was curl of B equal to mu 0 J. J is the current density. Now curl of B equal to mu 0 J, that was the Ampere circuital law. Then what happened? Maxwell corrected that law and added this extra term, epsilon 0 daily by del t. So Ampere's law with Maxwell's correction, and this is the correction term. The second part is the correction term. So I will discuss it later, but lectures are very limited. That is the problem. So very small number of lectures, it is not very less. So to discuss in detail, this is very problematic. So what is the question that you will get it from here? That is the Maxwell's equation. Write down Maxwell's equation and their significance. So this is the first Maxwell equation. This gives the Gauss law in electrostatics. Second Maxwell equation, this gives the Gauss law in magnetostatics. Third Maxwell equation, it gives the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. And the fourth law gives the Ampere's law with Maxwell correction. So these are four Maxwell's equation, but they are all differential form. No integration sign you are getting. So these are all differential divergence of E. What is the meaning of this? This means I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z. So all these equations are given in differential form. Now, Maxwell equation in vacuum or free space. So it is the previous one. This is the differential equation of Maxwell equation. Now, taking some approximation. That is Maxwell's equation in vacuum or free space. What will be? Now in vacuum, rho is what? Rho is the volume charge density. Volume charge density means charge per unit volume. So here J, that is J is also J, current density. So this is also zero in that is free space or vacuum. Then what will happen? Initially, what was there? Divergence of E equal to rho by epsilon zero. This is the first Maxwell equation. But if in vacuum or free space, what is rho? What is the value of rho in vacuum or free space? What I said just? In vacuum or free space, what is the value of rho?
Zero.
Zero. So what is the first Maxwell equation in free space? Say
divergence of
E equal to zero. So that I have written divergence of E equal to zero. Then the second equation, there is nothing to put because divergence of B in the right hand side, nothing is there except zero. So right hand side is already zero and not depending on rho or something. So second Maxwell equation, it is also the same. So free space or vacuum, second Maxwell equation remains the same. So that I have written divergence of B equal to zero. Curl of E equal to minus del B by del T. This is also not changing. So this is also not changing. So second one is not changing. Third one is not changing. Curl of E equal to minus del B by del T. This is the third Maxwell equation. This is also not changing in free space or vacuum. Second Maxwell equation is also not changing in free space or vacuum. Only the first Maxwell equation is changing because it was rho by epsilon zero and rho is zero. So divergence of E equal to zero. And the fourth Maxwell equation, C. Condition here in vacuum rho zero or J equal to zero, current density zero. So here in for Maxwell equation, what is zero? I said, what is zero? In for Maxwell equation, what is zero?
J is zero.
So in free space or vacuum, this J has zero value. So what is the fourth Maxwell equation in free space? Say, curl of B equal to what?
Mu naught epsilon naught.
Mu naught epsilon naught del by del T. So mu zero epsilon zero del by del T. So these are the equations. It is given frequently in exam. Write down the Maxwell's equation in vacuum or free space. So first one is divergence of E equal to zero. Second one is divergence of B equal to zero. Then third one is curl of E equal to minus del B by del T. Then curl of B equal to mu zero epsilon zero del by del T. So now if it is offline exam, you probably may be given or for you have offline exam because the offline class will be started. And you may have to give the offline exam later. I don't know exactly, but if it is offline exam, then what type of question you get? 15 marks question is there in long answer type question there. Then so in 15 marks division you will get that 4 plus 6 by or like this. So long answer type and short answer type also will be given. Total 15 marks question you will get when there it will be given. Say explain the Maxwell differential form of Maxwell's equation, or write down the Maxwell's equation and write down the significance of the Maxwell's equation. So write down the Maxwell's equation and also the significance of the equation. Then say it is given for 4 marks or 3 marks. Then it will be given, write down the Maxwell's equation in free space or vacuum. Say it is given for 2 marks. So you can see that is very, for short answer type question. So it will be given for say 2 marks. So write down the Maxwell's equation in vacuum or free space, that will be given for 2 marks. And also it can be said, so whatever I have discussed here, this is a differential form of Maxwell equation. So also it may be written that it, write down the differential form of Maxwell equation. And if it is not written that is differential form, then either you can write differential form or you can write integral form. So any form you will write. So 4 equations are given for differential form. So this is for free space and vacuum. Electric wave equation in free space. This is very, very important. Electromagnetic wave equation in free space. Also, it may be given for 3 marks or 4 marks. Develop or deduce the electromagnetic wave equation in free space. Now, for electric field, from where I'm starting, curl of E equal to minus del B by del T. So, what is this equation? This equation, curl of E equal to minus del B by del T. I have just discussed this. Maxwell equation number?
3.
Number 3. So we know this equation, curl of equal to minus del B by del T. Now what I am taking? Taking curl on both sides of the above equation. So both sides I am taking the curl. So what? Curl of E. So this is the curl. So this is the curl and curl of E. So curl of E. That is equal to what? Here it is minus del B by del T in the right hand side already. So take the curl on this. So minus I have written here. So curl of del B by del T. So taking the curl on both sides. So this is the form. Now how I am writing this? Del del T I have written here. And this curl of B I have written like this. So this is the form. Now this form, curl of E, that can be break. This is the mathematical formula for vector. So remember this formula. Any vector is, if it is maybe given here, so curl of that vector, that may be written like this. It may be written like this, and then after that the right hand side it is minus del del T of curl of B. As it is written in the right hand side. And now this this form, curl of E, that is, this is written like that. What I'm doing after that, now curl of B equal to, say here, think here, what is written in free space? So I have to only consider the Maxwell equation in free space, not the general Maxwell equation. So whatever Maxwell's equation in free space I have deduced, it is written, you have to consider only that. So curl of B equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 del E by del T. What is this Maxwell equation? The number equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 del E by del T. What is the number of Maxwell equation here? 1, 2, 3, 4 options given. Say, fourth Maxwell equation. Maxwell equation, but in free space, because there is no J here. That I'm going here. So this is the fourth Maxwell equation, but in here, where? Free space, because there is no J. Here in the general form of Maxwell equation, in differential form, J was there. But when it is free space, J is 0. So this is the form. Value is here. And in free space, what is the first Maxwell equation? In free space, what is the first Maxwell equation?
Curl of B and E vector equal to 0.
Curl of E equal to 0. Curl of E equal to 0. This is the first Maxwell equation in free space. So we are using these two equations. Now what I am doing? In this for left hand side. In the left hand side, inside the bracket, what is written? Inside the bracket, what is written? Yeah, what is This is
curl of E.
Divergence of E. Now, what is the value of divergence of E from the Maxwell equation in free space?
Zero.
Now, if I put this value here, then what is the term remain in left hand side? This value is zero. This value is zero because divergence of E is already zero according to this equation. So what we may see are only minus grad square E. Okay. So this term only remains. So actually curl of E, it is divided in two parts. This is the mathematical formula. And the first part is zero from this equation. So in left hand side only remains grad square E. See, left hand side only remains grad square E. Okay. Now come to the right hand side. Minus del del T of which? To say, what is this? Pronunciation, what is the minus del del T of which? Say anyone. Minus del del T of which? Curl of B. Now, this value curl of B is already given there. So I will just substitute this value. In this place of curl of B, what I will write? So here, in this place of curl of B, what I will write? This value. What is the value of curl of B?
Epsilon naught del by del t.
So is it written here? Is it written here? Minus del del t of this? From here? Right hand side? Okay. So right hand side is substituted. And the left hand side divergence of E is zero. So this remains minus grad square E. So what is this relation? Minus grad square E equal to minus del del t of mu zero epsilon zero del E by del t. Or cancel the minus from both sides. So the equation remains as grad square E equal to mu zero epsilon zero del 2E by del T square. And differential equation. What was the question? Electromagnetic wave equation for free space. So there are electric field, electromagnetic wave. That means there are electric field and also the magnetic field. So for electric field, what will be the wave equation? Therefore, electric field, the wave equation will be grad square E equal to mu zero epsilon zero del E by del T. Dimensional, you know, grad square is there. So it is three-dimensional wave equation for electric field in free space. So three dimension, because grad square is what? Del 2y? Already I have discussed all these things. Grad square means what? Don't you know? Del 2 by del x square plus del 2 by del y square plus del 2 by del z square. Is it known or not?
No, ma'am.
Grad square? Don't know?
No, ma'am.
Grad square equal to mu zero epsilon zero del 2 by del t square. So grad square means del 2 by del x square plus del 2 by del y square plus del 2 by del z square. As x, y, z, all are present here. So it is three-dimensional. Dimension, if it is only x is there. If I write it, del 2e by del x square, then what will be the equation? Three-dimension or one-dimension? If I write del 2 by del x square, then E. Meaning del 2e by del x square. Then what is the equation? Three-dimension or one-dimension?
Three-dimension.
If I write here in place of grad square E, if I write del 2E by del x square, then what is the equation? One dimension or three dimension? It is one dimension. If I write del 2E by del y square only, nothing is here. If that is written here, del 2E by del y square equal to mu zero epsilon zero del 2E by del t square. And this is one dimensional. But here it is grad square. That means del 2E, del 2 by del x square, del 2 by del y square plus del 2 by del z square. I'm just briefly I'm explaining. Time is almost over. So I can't give. I'm just deriving this because This may be given in your this may help you for your exam. Very quickly. If it is given in the option, what is grad square? You can't write them. All these things I have discussed, all these things. So what is the meaning of this? You know this thing?
Nabla.
Huh? Don't know. You know this? What is the meaning of this?
Gradient.
Do you know this? So if you take, if you write it in this way, then how will you write? Dot is there, remember. Dot I hat little x plus j hat little y little z. Now say, what is the value? Say quickly, say anyone, what is the value? Are I had dot I hat is 1, I had dot j hat 0, I had dot k hat 0. So this term, when I will multiply this with this all 3, then this two term will be 0, because I had dot j hat 0. So only the first term remains, because I had dot I hat is there. So what is the first term?
1.
Del 2 by del
x. I had dot I hat 1. So what is remaining here? Del x and del x. So what? How I will write this?
Del square, del square,
del 2 by del x square. Then with this term, with this term, this term, with this whole, this term with this whole. So j dot I hat what? 0, 0. J dot j hat only 1. J dot k hat 0. So what is the term remaining for the second part?
Del 2 by del y square.
And for the third one?
Del 2.
So grad square, what is the meaning? I say, what is the meaning of grad square? It's a grad square. Del 2 by del x square plus del 2 by del y square plus del 2 by del z square. Is it three dimensional? Say something, is it three-dimensional? Yes, it is three-dimensional, because x, y, z all are present here. If I write only, del 2 by del x square. So what is the dimension? One dimension, two dimension, or three dimension?
One dimension.
One dimension.
One.
So only x is here. If I only write del 2 by del y square, only dimensional along y direction. That I want to say. So this is the reason. Grad square E equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 del 2 E by del t square. So this is the three-dimensional wave equation for electric field in free space. And in the same way, I will share the notes. In the same way, you can prove for magnetic field and same type of equation. See, grad square B equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 del 2 B by del T square. So this is also the three-dimensional wave equation for vector field in free space. So I will discuss it later, just go through it. So these two equations are very important. So this is similar with this grad square psi. This is the wave equation. Now I am comparing these two with this. And this, what is say? This is for electric field equation. This is magnetic field equation. And compare with the general equation of wave, grad square equal to 1 by c square del 2 psi by del t square. Then what is the value of 1 by c square? Say from here. If you compare these two equations, for this is for electric field equation, magnetic field equation, comparing with general wave equation. partial differential equation for wave. This is the partial differential equation for wave. If you compare, what value of 1 by c square you are getting? C square equal to mu zero epsilon zero. So c is what? C is what? 1 by mu zero epsilon zero. Okay. Now put the value of mu zero and epsilon zero. It is given. So you are getting this. That is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That is speed of light in vacuum. So this is the equation for electric field. So this is the equation of electric field. This is the equation of magnetic field. And if you compare this with the formal differential form of partial differential form of wave, then you can get the velocity c as this. So you are calculating the velocity, and this is the velocity of light. So electromagnetic wave, conclude, light is electromagnetic wave. So from here, as you are getting the velocity of light, so you can say that light is electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave. So electric field and magnetic field, the velocity, that is the velocity of light. Again, you are getting the velocity as c, and here also you are getting the velocity as c. So the value you have, so light wave, this is the velocity of light in vacuum. So we can say that is light. Light is an electromagnetic wave. So this is our conclusion. This part is very, very important. Just mark it. Deduce the electromagnetic wave equation in free space. And also this is given, c equal to 1 by root over mu 0 epsilon 0. It is given in MCQ question, offline or online. Maybe anything, but this is very important for your MCQ. Frequently given in MCQ. C is this. For electromagnetic wave propagation, the velocity of light, it is given as 4 options are given. So very important. As the time is over, I'm just leaving my class and give the exam tomorrow in your scheduled time. Okay.